Okay, here's another League of Legends game coming your way, this time with Cho'Gath in the jungle. And since I'm playing a different position for him, I'm packing my other skin. Anyway, lane matchups are as follows. We have Jinx partner with Braum, bot against Blitzcrank and Graves. We have Malzahar mid against Yasuo. I'm Cho'Gath in the jungle against Nautilus, and we have Teemo top against Malphite. So the Teemo Malphite lane is interesting, to say the least. It's one of those lanes that can go either way. It does slightly favor Malphite from the very beginning, though. Anyway, we'll cover that as it goes, but that's a lane where Teemo really actually does need to itemize for MR to begin things, since that will mitigate a lot of Malphite's harass. But as for Cho'Gath, let's go over how he works. Your passive is Carnivore. Whenever you kill an enemy, you regain health and mana. The amount scales off of... And I had to take Q first, but if they help with the leash, that won't be the end of the world. Okay, that should be good enough. It's 390 to start things off with. But starting with your Q is not really desirable. Normally you want to go with your E because it does give you AoE clear. It's just, they wanted to invade, we made sure to turn that invasion into a one-way trip. And unfortunately, I probably actually shouldn't have queued that. Since I don't have blue buff for mana sustain, I'm only going to be getting the regen from my passive. And this is going to be a rough lane for Malzahar to start things off with, but once he has a little bit more AP and can just clear the way with his visions, then he won't have much trouble at all. He will have to be on guard for an all-in from Yasuo, though. And... wow, Yasuo is actually pretty healthy there. Not seeing a lot of options, so I'm just going to jungle for a bit longer. Teemo could be in danger. And there's Yasuo. And Nautilus. Run faster, young Yordle.
An ally has been slain.
But yeah, if you want to be that aggressive, you need wards. Yeah, Malzahar is really immovable. And I'm going to be maxing the E for the clear. Going to take the golems and then probably gonna head back. Malphite would have actually been my best gank opportunity, but there was no way in hell that guy was going to be sticking around. Who knows what he's doing. And I'm going to be going for the Wraith, so that's why I'm picking up the Spirit Stone instead of the Golem. The Golem does synergize with Cho'Gath's passive on his ult now, but I'm just not a fan of the item. It doesn't give you this type of sustain you actually need. Hey, you're excited. This was just warded, I bet. Malzahar is playing with fire. Just spawned. It's gonna be a little slower than normal because I had to start with my Q rather than my E. But Malz should be going back sooner rather than later because Yasuo can come back with an item advantage and just kill him. Malzahar didn't go back, so now he's at the disadvantage in that lane. And I think it can get ugly regardless of whether or not I show up. He's got a cutlass for sustain. So that was kind of a good call on his part. I wanted him to get closer so I could knock him into the turret and possibly turn and feast, but no luck. And my blue buff could be up for grabs here. And now that I think about it, it also doesn't help that he's level 8.
An ally has been slain. slain.
Give this to Malzahar. Not gonna take this for very long, so don't wait. And he does have his ult now, so... Lane. We're gonna need to put up some wards. He has a large... Oh, God. That's not a good item to get.
Your team has destroyed a turret. Your turret has been destroyed.
Running. Is we lost all of our outer turrets right there, but we might be able to make something out of this in the end. I know Jinx took this, so... Shit. Need him to stun Graves there.
Your
start applying counter pressure now. He might be able to take that on his own. If not, I can help him. Trying to drop my pink ward in here so we can see the movements around the Baron pit. At this point, it's pretty obvious we're up against a pre-made. I just don't know how big it is. Push out the top line, unless they're still going to be making catches somewhere. And they're just really out roaming us. Pretty bad. As long as he got the E off, that should be the end of Yasuo.
Rampage.
He didn't. This is our last inner turret, which is pretty much guaranteed to be their next target. sitting on 3,000 gold, and I kind of need to go back. So I know Yasuo is here. Person is getting fed. But now I can actually spend my money on some upgrades. I'm not actually able to use my passive right here, but yeah, I'm gonna tank up. Here, I'm gonna hold on to my money. Let's see. Malphite. He might be going full tank with the exception of that gauntlet. So, I'm going to be stacking armor this game. I'm gonna need a Thornmail for sure. Maybe even going as far as to get a Frozen Heart. And they got it. For us by any means. We don't have Teemo either.
An ally has been slain.
Gonna need home guards. Seriously, do that. Okay. So the other advantage to the Thornmail that I just picked up is that I now have 300 armor. I can now face tank a turret if we need to. About Cho'Gath, you can use your smite early and finish the job with your feast. Okay, the blue buff is on spam, and they should be staying on 40% CDR. Malphite could teleport in here, so we have to be on guard for that. It's coming from behind. Full size yet. So staying behind there is begging to die.
An ally has been slain. An enemy has been slain. An ally has been slain.
Okay. And if that's a meme, I'm not familiar with it. It's going to add on some power to my feast and my Q, so my spells will hurt. Beyond the CC, the enemy will have very good reason to evade them whenever possible. Plus, when Yasuo gets his... Okay. So whenever Yasuo actually got his armor penetration thing from Last Breath, I could actually Zhonya's to evade some of it. Yeah, he doesn't have Rylai's. New position, and we get to show off a little bit more of how Cho is pretty flexible. You can take him top, you can take him jungle, you can actually take him mid. I've done a video of that. And even under certain circumstances, you can even take him bot, because that feast makes for a nice execute when no one's expecting it. It's true damage, so the only way to mitigate it is to build health. Anyway, I'll go into more detail in the description. I'm the Hero of Light, thanks for watching, and goodbye.